The second era of American history that we're going to look at is from about 1830 to 1910. This is a time period that, in federalism terms, we often use the term dual federalism to describe. So the first part of American history showed like a stronger national government emerging. And what you see during this time period is that in reaction to that national government becoming strong during that time period, you sort of see a swing back in the opposite direction. And this is a time period that, in reaction to that first, you begin to see the state governments try to reclaim like their power. This is an era called dual federalism because the states are trying to push the national government out of doing things they think are powers that belong to them. So they're trying to push the national government like back, and they're trying to establish like clearly defined powers that belong to the states and push the national government back into powers they think belong to them. Most AP government textbooks use the metaphor of a layer cake to try and illustrate this concept, because if you cut like a layer cake open, you can clearly see like the different layers within the cake, right? Whether it's like chocolate, vanilla, like something else. And this is meant to represent the metaphor of what the state governments were trying to accomplish during this time period, which is like pushing the national government out of their sort of realm and being able to see clearly what is a power that should belong to the national government, what is a power that should belong to the states. So this is an era of stronger state government sort of like powers. You see these sort of ideas reflected in many of these significant Supreme Court decisions during this time period that tend either to support the rights of like states and their governments or take power away from the national government. One example is the famous Dred Scott case in 1857, which basically invalidated the Missouri Compromise line. If you remember talking about this from a previous American history class, the national government had passed a law decades earlier that drew this green line on the map that corresponds to the southern border of Missouri. It basically decided, right, as a national government law, that any future area coming in as a state above this green line would have to come in as a free state, and anybody coming in below the line would come in as a slave state. This lawsuit basically took this power away from the national government, erased this green line, and decided that it would be up to the future state to decide if it wanted to be a free state or a slave state, not this line drawn on the map by the national government. So that increased state powers. Also, the significant case of Plessy v. Ferguson in 1896, which basically allows the states to continue with their segregation policies as long as their segregation policies enabled things to be separate but equal. So this basically validated state segregation policies and allowed the states to continue to implement segregation policies. Again, if they adhered by the separate but equal policy, which obviously we know as American history progressed, they had no interest in doing so.